Got any boards? Raise your hand if your parents are on public welfare, like whether they receive food stamps, WIC, or SSI, GR. Raise your hand if you live in a community where there's gang violence. Raise your hand if you live in a community where you see drugs in your community. Raise your hand if you ever felt overwhelmed. If you ever felt sad. Raise your hand if you ever heard your parents say they're stressed. Raise your hand if you didn't have money to buy school lunch. Raise your hands if utilities have been turned off in your household. Raise your hand if your parents work two or more jobs or no job at all. Raise your hand if you wasn't raised by your parents, your mom or dad. Raise your hands if your parents are in jail or incarcerated. Raise your hands if you are raising your siblings. Raise your hand if you feel that it's hard to live up to your parents / society expectations of you. Raise your hand if you ever felt alone. What does all these things create inside of you?
So for me, all those questions answer yes. And so for me, it creates stress, it creates anger, low self-esteem, and depression. That's what I battled with throughout high school and even now to today. But we're not alone. So all these celebrities we see and we want to live up to society and social media, we're not the only one that's experiencing this. Adele, Dwayne Johnson, aka The Rock, Jerry West, Nicki Minaj, all these celebrities all struggle with these mental health elements. And we aspire and we try to live up to the limitations and be like social media says, right? So I'm going to play a clip real fast from The Rock.
That with depression, one of the most important things you can realize is that you're not alone. You're not the first to go through it. You're not going to be the last to go through it. And oftentimes, it happens. You feel like you're alone. And you feel like it's only you. And you're in your bubble. And I wish I had someone at that time who could just pull me aside and, hey, it'd be okay. It'd be okay. But I wish I knew that. Just gotta remember, hold on to that fundamental quality of faith. Have faith. But on the other side of your pain is something good.
The Huffington Post reports that The Rock revealed that he suffered from depression in his early 20s as a result of being passed over by the NFL. After playing college football at the University of Miami, he didn't make an NFL
I think people in the audience are being cues to have to calm down and to relax and to breathe. I struggle with this baby. I struggle pretty bad. But it's part of who I am, and I have to accept that as an adult now. But growing up in a single-parent household, growing up with drugs and gangs in my community, growing up having to raise my siblings, created a lot of stress in me. I wanted to run track, but it cost money to play sports. My mother was on welfare, so she couldn't afford to be able to buy me this high tennis to play run track or to be able to buy the uniform. So I didn't get to play. I had to work very early on in high school, from ninth grade up until I graduated. I had to work to be able to support to buy the things in high school, yearbooks, prom, all that I built my own. My mother was a very strong woman, but she couldn't afford to do it. So a lot of that created a lot of stress inside of me. Being only 14, having to be able to deal in and how to be an adult very early on. I had two younger siblings, younger than me, my younger brother, and my younger sister that I helped raise. I'm a child myself, being a mother. To my siblings, which was hard. So that stress and anxiety produced a lot of anger inside of me. When I say anger, like my whole thing was, if you don't like me, two things can happen. Either be quiet, let's get down. And I was more so, let's get down. So how many years did it take to graduate high school? All right. So I went to five different high schools because of my anger. I started off at Cabrillo, got in a lot of fights, had a crazy mouth, pop off at you at any given moment. That kicked out of Cabrillo, I want to say my first week in 10th grade, said some ill things to one of the teachers. They were like, you know what, we're going to give you some nights, but we can't meet the regular population. So I went to school from 1-4 at Cabrillo to Mace school. I was there maybe half of the semester, and I think I got let go again because of this mouth of mine. I think I sent some ill things to the police. And they let me go. So they sent me to Renaissance. Was at Renaissance my 10th grade year. I didn't finish my credits at Renaissance because what happened again? This mouth, somebody says something, pop off, down the fight. So long as you're like, you know what, tired of you, kick me out of this tree, booted me out, send me to EPHS and Big Speed Notice. At this time, all of my friends were still going to school. I'm still dealing with living at home. I think at this point, I think I'm living in a motel with my mother because we got evicted from where we was living at, so we're living in a motel. So now I'm like stressed inside of me. Now I'm mad, embarrassed, living in a motel. My friends are still going to school, but not me. So 10th grade year, I finished at EPHS. Then 11th grade year, something clicked. And I was like, I don't want to do this no more. Like, I want to be at school with my friends. I want to be at home. And then you at home, you got clean up, your mama yelling, you know, got to do chores. I want to be at home with my mom all day. So I'm like, you know what? I don't know what I want, but I know I don't want this. Water grade at least out of Long Beach, I knew I didn't want that. I wanted more. So didn't play sports. Not really so good in the classroom. I think I can see the degree, okay? So I can manage to see a C 2.0. So I wrote a district, I wrote a letter to the Unified School District. I don't know what I said, but I asked them, like, I changed, I'm repairing them, revised, I'm good now. Let me back in the district. Surprisingly, they did. And at that time, going to Poly was a big thing. Like, if you go to Poly, like, you was for the time. And I didn't play sports, so I thought I was a girl. I'm going to Poly. Poly is just that, you know, I'm going to take you. Came to Poly, still had this math, but not too bad. Came to Poly. I did well, I graduated. But it was enough. I'm very tall, right? So no, I don't play basketball, I don't know volleyball. But I wanted to be a model, I was kind of skinny lady, right? But at that time they said I was a plus size model. I was like 150. So imagine me at 150 at 16. I was pretty skinny. But they said, no, girl, you're big. So you're gonna be free. So I became depressed. I became really satisfied. Because I felt like I wasn't going to make it out. I wasn't really good at school, didn't play any sports, so I became depressed inside. And I actually really had very low self-esteem because of that. So I started making myself grow up. Right. Instead, I was too big, I wasn't going to, you know, couldn't be a model, I wasn't good at sports, so I think I was looking at being a model for me, but I and she was the sweetest thing ever. Actually, I Polly Powell, the sweetest thing ever. And she kind of mentored and kind of coached me. So I left Polly. I went to Long Beach City College, lived like high school all over again. Friends hanging out, wasn't going to class. I got the financial aid money. I thought I was balling, right? So I got the financial aid money, didn't use it for no use, didn't really pass none of my classes. So that worked out. I ended up getting pregnant with my son. He's somewhere around here. He's 10, boy, he's up 11 now. So I got pregnant with my son, and I realized, like, okay, something got to change. This is not going to work. Lady, you got to get it together. So I left Long Beach City. I ended up going to El Camino Conca College and literally changed the trajectory of my life. Totally. Like I said, still wasn't really smart, you know. Like I said, need degrees. Went to El Camino College, still battling, you know, with that anger inside because I was poor. And people are like, how can poor, you know, college a struggle? Like, how can being poor? I'm like, poor is a lot. You know, that's a big struggle being poor. You know, I remember, like, you don't appreciate a dollar until you don't have a dollar. I remember I had a dollar to buy a burger one time at school because at school just started. And so you don't appreciate just the little things. So I struggled with that. But at El Camino College, I realized that I'm going to make a difference. I don't have to play sports to make it all good. I don't have to be a model. I don't have to be a video vixen. I don't have to do all these things that celebrities tell you to do in order to make it out and be successful. I said, I'm going to try to do education to make it out. So I did. I left El Camino with an AA, so scholarly. I went to Cal State, LA. Got my BA in sociology and law society with my neurotology. I left Cal State LA and I went to Cal State LA. And me, right? I told y'all, I mean, I graduated with 2.7. And so I'm like, I want to get my master's, so I applied to USC. But I'm like, I know I'm getting USC there at 2.7. You need to be reminded of USC. So I put it off for forever. I put it off, put it off. It kept happening. I'm like, y'all know I'm going to get in. That's what my patient be like. I'm not going to get in. Stop having me to apply. So long story short, kid you not, I applied, like I want to say beginning of August. I want to say 2 weeks later, I got into USC with a 2.7 GPA.
But at some point, if you would have stayed on course, somebody would intervene. You would have been Mr. Gray. But by holding in,
oh my goodness, it makes you angry. Trust me, I know firsthand.
So I thank God for my support.